Yo, what's up? It's Patrick from Guy in the Cube. And I was talking to someone recently and they're like, Patrick, we want to dynamically highlight the top or the bottom number of values in a bar chart. Can you do that with Power BI? It was like, we tried, you can't. I was like, sure you can. It was like, no, you can't. I was like, stay tuned. If you're finding this for the very first time, be sure to hit that subscribe button to stay up to date on all the videos from both Adam and this guy. Okay, I don't have a lot to say. I don't have a lot to say. Somebody asked me this question about highlighting bars and sorting them and descending and ascending. They were arguing saying you can't do it. And I was like, of course you can. I'm gonna make a video about it. So you guys know what I like to do. Instead of all this talking, let's do what? Let's head over to my laptop. They have a report and they showed me this report. He's like, okay, when I select the year, see how the items switch. So it's January, May, and December. If I choose 2013, it's March, September, and October. These are my top 3 months, right? Where I had the most sales at. I'm like, ah, that's cool. I was like, how did you do it? He's like, let me show you. So he says, I created this measure. So I go here and he has this measure. I was like, okay, I'm gonna copy this measure. I see what you're doing. It's, you know, if the rank is less than or equal to 3, your top 3, what this color, otherwise that color. He's like, yeah. And then I went on that element and I set up conditional colors, right? So I went to data colors and I set up the condition to use that measure. And I'm like, all right, cool. I'm like, but what do you want? How do you want this to work? He's like, well, can we have like a little slider or a little slicer where people can choose top 1, top 2, top 3 and have the bar chart, you know, reflect that new number, right? That new top or bottom. I was like, yeah, you can do this. Guess what you would use? What if? Let me show you. I copied his measure and I went over to DAX Studio. I added a variable and I specified a number. And then I went down in his if statement and said, if the rank is less than or equal to that number, right, make it the color, otherwise make it this color. And then I just kind of simulated how Power BI would run the query using summarized columns. I passed the month, I did a treat as so I can, you know, filter the data based on the year, like he would do on his report. And then I displayed some data. So let's go ahead and run this. So we run this and you can see how there's the top 3, right? There's the top 3. And I say, watch this. If I just change this to another one, boom, there's the top 5 and on and so forth. He was like, Patrick, this is amazing, but how can I add that interactivity to the report? Watch this. This is where the what if came into play. I duplicated this page because I don't like to break people's stuff. I went to modeling, I said new parameter, and then I called it top n right there. I said, here's, it's gonna be a whole number from 0. And I said, what's the maximum? He said about 6. I said, okay, you can always go and adjust this. Let's increment it by 1 because we want 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And well, he said, set the default at 3 and then add the slicer to the page. So when I did that, it added the slicer to the page. It created a table for me. So let's go take a peek at what that table looks like. So you can see there's a table, just has a list of items. And then it created a measure for me. I have a video somewhere out on the YouTubes about what if parameters, but you can see, okay, so that's what it did. And so then after all that was created, I went back over to DAX Studio. And what I did was I replaced the hard coded value with the measure, which will be assigned to the variable, which is used down here in the if statement. And then I add an additional treat as an additional filter to my query down here and say, let's simulate this. So I'm going to start at 1. So if I run this, you see that's top 1. And then if I went outside of the range, so my maximum value was 6. If I choose 7, it's going to default to 3. You can see. But if I hit 6, it'll do 6. And he was like, all right, I see you, Patrick. I see you. So I said, now let's go over to Power BI Desktop. So we went over to Power BI Desktop. I went to that bar chart and all I did was I went to his data colors after I created the new measure and I adjusted it from V1 to V2, like boom. Now we can use this little slicer. If we go all the way to 1, it's gonna highlight just the top 1. If we go all the way to 6, it's gonna highlight the top 6. And if we go in the middle to 3, it's just gonna highlight the top 3. He was like, all right, but Mr. Smarty Pants, I need to change the direction. I want the top or the bottom. Like, oh man, are your requirements ever gonna stop, dude? I was like, but I think it can be done. Let me show you. So I headed back over to DAX Studio with my V2 measure in hand, and I added another variable. Because rank has a parameter for direction, descending or ascending, I popped the variable in, I said, we're gonna go descending, and I ran it, and then I got an error. He was looking like this. He was like, Mr. Smarty Pants, ain't gonna work. I was like, hang on. I looked at this and I go, oh, I didn't realize instead of descending or ascending, you can pass zero or false for descending and one and true for ascending. So I said, okay, let's give this a go. So I went over here, did zero, boom. All right, all right. And let's do ascending. Boom, all right, all right. Okay, so it's working. I'm like, all right, cool, this works. This works, I'm excited. I decided I'm gonna go back to Power BI Desktop and I created a table that contained, if you want the bottom, if you want the top, and I put some keys so I can use integers in my DAX and use text in my slicer selection. And then I created a measure that brought back the selected value, very similar to the what if, and then said default to true, or it could be one, true or one, either one will work. So then I headed back over to DAX Studio and I replaced that hard coded value with my measure. I added another filter in my query down here for bottom. I'm just simulating what Power BI would be doing, right? So this is me, my slicer selections right here in the summarized columns. So I ran this and then I got the same error. The exact same error. I was like, oh no. And he was just standing there like, not so smart, huh? Not as smart as you think. I was like, hang on a second. Got an idea. Like a light bulb went off. I tinkered with this a bit, couldn't figure out how to make that work. And so I just used plain old logic. So I put the measure there. I kept the measure there for top or bottom. And then I said, hey, if the direction is zero, you know, that's bottom. Otherwise, give me the top. So we ran this to make sure it works. So you can see bottom, right? There's a bottom three. So let's change this to top. There we go. There's my top three. I'm like, all right. And I headed back over to Power BI Desktop, added my new measure. You can see there's my new measure right there. I added it as a measure in my model. And then I added the display as a horizontal slicer. So now watch this. So I'm gonna say, give me the bottom one. So there's the bottom one. Now give me the top one. There's the top one. Look at there. Give me the top three. Boom, there's the top three. Give me the bottom three. Boom. And then I was standing there like, yes, I am that smart. I kid, right? It's just a lot of tinkering, right? Adam and I do this a lot, right? We're just learning the clicks, tinkering about, and a lot of times we solve problems. Okay, I love to know if you guys are solving this a different way. If you have any questions or comments, you guys know what to do. Post it in the comments below. If it's your first time visiting the Guy in the Cube channel, hit that subscribe button. If you like my video, give me a big thumbs up. As always, from Adam and myself, thanks for watching, and we'll see you in the next video.